There are many types of design formats in Canva when it comes to social media, especially for Instagram. You can create a reel, a story, a post, or a carousel. A carousel is a series of pages one after the other within the same post. And a seamless carousel is when you have images or graphics on those pages that look like they're blending between one page and the next without any breaks or seams. And that's what we're going to create today. My name is Kat. This is Canva Catter Day. Let's get to it. To find some of those carousel images in Canva, you can just do a simple search for Instagram carousel or Instagram seamless carousel, and Canva will give you some of these results. So let me show you the difference between the two. So we have this Instagram post right here, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit. And you can see that each of the pages is completely different. Yes, it has the same theme, but the colors are different from one page to the next. This would be considered a regular carousel post because you don't have any graphics or photos that are blending from one page to the next. So that would be a regular Instagram carousel. Let me show you that now what it looks like if you pick a seamless carousel. I'm going to zoom on this one right here. And if I look between the pages, you can see that I've got these graphics that come off the one side of the page and go onto the other side of the page. It does it down here at the bottom, up here at the top, and so on between each of those pages. That's going to make the carousel look a little more seamless. It's going to make it look like it's one cohesive piece of design because those elements are blending as you swipe through those pages. Now, there are two different ways that you can create your seamless carousel. One is by using the separate page method, which is what this template is right here. And the other is the second method that I'm going to show you in just a few minutes. But let me open this one and I want to show you how they move the elements on the page. So here we have page one and page two, and they are completely separate pages. But if you view them in grid view, you can see where those elements blend from one to the other. In order to create that, what you would do is take the element and simply put it into position on your page. So this Canva creator took this blob element and she put it right here on this portion of the page. She simply dragged it and moved it. You can see there's a whole unit right there, and she put it into position. And then on the second page, she came down here and aligned it so that it would perfectly match the other graphic. And it takes a little bit of work to do this because you have to kind of line everything up. You've got to use your rulers and guides and make sure that everything lines up perfectly between each of those pages. And this is perfectly okay. You can certainly do them this way. But let me show you how I create my carousel images because I happen to find this method just a little bit easier. First thing you're going to want to do is take a look at this carousel image. Now you'll notice right off the bat, it's an entirely different dimension than the other one. This right here has your standard Instagram dimension. It is a square dimension. Instagram posts are 1080 pixels by 1080 pixels. That's for a standard square image. And then if you want to go to the taller portrait size, it's 1080 pixels by 1350. It's a little bit on the taller side. So this one right here is a square format. And then over here, you'll notice this one's a little longer. This is my whole design. It's a lot longer, but I've got it separated by these divider lines. And then I can take all of the elements on my page and see how they'll look all together without having to go from page to page and moving those design elements and kind of lining them up, make sure they're exactly in line with each other between page and page. So let's do this from scratch. First thing you want to do is go to the Canva homepage and you want to create a design. I'm just going to use the custom size right here. In order to create these pages so that they look like one blends into the next, we want one design file. Depending on how many pages you want in that Instagram post, you need to multiply the number of pages you want by the dimensions of the Instagram post. Let me show you. You gotta do a little bit of math, but I have already done the math for you. If you want to use a square Instagram format, you would simply take the number of pages and multiply it by 1080 pixels. That's how wide an Instagram post is. So if you want two pages, you would take that 1080, multiply it by two, and it's going to give you 2160. If you want three pages, you'll multiply that 1080 number by three, and it's going to give you 1340. That's the width, the overall width of your design. If you want to use the taller Instagram posts, you're going to do the exact same thing. You're still going to multiply by 1080 because the width of the Instagram post does not change. The only thing changes in a portrait post is its height. So you'll simply multiply it the same way and just use this height of 1350 to give you that taller size. So I'm going to go back over here, and I already have right here, I've got 5400 by 1080. You'll notice in my dimensions that if I do 5400, that's going to give me a five-page post, a five-page carousel, which we are going to create. So I'm going to go back over here. I'm going to say create new design. And here is that long format. It's exactly like the format I showed you right here. That's the format we are going to use. So let me go back to, there we go, back over here. Let me move this tab over so I stay in where I'm supposed to be. Canva over here is going to give you some suggestions for designs. It's kind of treating it like a banner because it's nice and long. You can ignore that. I mean, you can use the banner if you want to, but you can basically ignore this. What you need to do now is, one, make sure you have rulers and guides enabled. If you don't, go up here to the File menu, click on File, click on View Settings, and make sure Show Rulers and Guides is checked. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Shift-R, and it will turn on your rulers and guides. The second thing you want to do is add some guides, because in order for us to make that little separation between the pages, we have to know where those pages are going to fall. So you're going to click Add Guides, and you have some choices here. You can add some columns, you can add grids. We're going to go over here to Custom. We already know we need five pages. You can see by default, Canva is kind of defaulting to this 12 column layout. We're not going to use that. So click on Custom, and over here under Columns, enter the amount of pages that you need. In this case, it's five. And we want the gap, that's this section right here, we want the gap to be at zero because we don't really need that gap. So we're going to make it zero. And then click Add Guides. And Canva adds those guides for you automatically. They are perfectly evenly spaced to that 1080 width when you go to create your designs. Then you will simply go to your elements. You can add your text. Let's go find a blob. Here's some graphics. I'll use it kind of similar to how they did this one right here. See these little blobs right here? We can do the same thing. You can simply add your graphics to the page. And let me just change that color so you can see it like that. And you can place them anywhere you would like on the page. If you want to add a couple more, let's go add a couple more. And let's go look for blobs again. Let's go add a couple more. Let's do this. See all. Grab this one right here. Kind of put it there. Kind of put that one there. And then you can add text, images, or whatever you would like that to be. One little tip I do want to mention, if you're going to take some graphics and images and make them merge in between these little seams, which will be where your pages break, if you're going to use a photo, make sure that your photo, especially if it's something like your face, make sure that it's not falling directly on that seam because it's going to look kind of weird. As people swipe through those pages, you don't want to see half the face. So if you're going to put a photo in here, you kind of want to make sure that you have the bulk of your photo on one page and sort of maybe like the last third or the last quarter on the other page. So let me go back to this finished one that I have right here. You can see I've got all of the text on each of those pages. And you can see right here, this is that little shape or that little blob that goes from one page to the other. And when you're swiping on that, it'll look like it's completely seamless. Now, I'm not going to go through the whole design process. I already just wanted to show you how it looks once you're finished. You can go in and design your carousel any way that you would like by adding your images and graphics. But I want to show you the important part when it comes to how do we get this into separate pages? we are going to use a free application called Pinetools right here, pinetools.com. This is completely free. It's actually a really neat website because there's a lot of elements in here that you can use in your graphic design. Once you go to pinetools.com, you want to go to where it says images, and we want to scroll. See, there's all these different tools that you can use. This is a really great website. You want to scroll down to where it says split image. This is what we're going to use. Click on split image. And here we're going to upload our finished carousel, and Pinetools is going to split it apart for us into those separate pages that we can then post to Instagram. So let me go grab my design. You want to download this as a PNG file. A little tip, I highly recommend that you take this PNG file and change the size to its maximum amount. And the reason I tell you this is because if you have a lot of text on your image, when you bring it into Pinetools and you cut it apart and then you upload it to Instagram, all social media platforms, they will render your graphics so that they're not quite as crisp as your original. And they all do that. That's just how they maintain server space so that they don't overload their servers. So you want to make sure that you change the image size to as high as you can possibly go as its maximum size. That way your text on the image is going to be nice and crisp and clean. So I'm going to leave it at its highest size right here, and I'm going to download it as a PNG. Click download. And then we're going to bring this into Pinetools. So I'm going to go over here to back to my Pinetools, and then let me go grab that download. And I'm going to click choose file, and it's going to bring me to my downloads folder, and I will click that carousel image. Here you go. Here's the preview of that carousel image. We already know we want to separate it into five pages because that's how we designed it. So here in Pinetools, where it says options, it says how to split the image. You want to split it horizontally because we're going to go horizontal. And then you want to tell it how many blocks or how many pages would you like this to be? We want it to be five because we want these to be equal pages across our social media account. So you want five equal blocks horizontally. You can also go over here and adjust the width of the block if you want to. You can come over here and just put 1080 because we know that's the width of that Instagram post. But keep it simple. Just put the number of pages that you have in there. And then you're going to click where it says split image. Pinetools is going to give you some options here. How do you want to split it? Split it. Click PNG because you want to click the same format. It's already generating five pieces, and then you can say download the file. You can download each one separately if you want to, but it's a little easier just to click the zip file. So we're going to click zip file, and it's going to download. Once it's done, let me bring it over and I will show you what it looks like. Here are those pages, and they are completely separated one to the other. And when they put them on Instagram and people swipe through it, it's going to scroll from one page to the next. It's such a great way to create some really fun and interactive posts because it encourages people to swipe. If they see an image that's on there and they see that part of it is missing off that first page, it actually encourages them to swipe and continue to see the rest of the images. You can also put like little arrows or little hands to kind of hint to them that you want them to swipe from one page to the next. But this way you can take that, that Canva design and separate it into those pages. There is one important thing to note. When I go back to my dimensions, you'll notice that I stopped at seven pages. And that's because Canva has a limitation on how large you can make your designs. You cannot go any wider than 8,000 pixels. That's the maximum limit. So if we were to go to seven pages, our maximum width of that post would be 7560 pixels. Any more than that, and Canva's going to yell at you and say, hey, you can't design anything wider than 8,000 pixels. So that's why I stopped at seven pages. But this is a really fun way to create your Instagram carousels. You can make them seamless and help create that engaging content on your Instagram account. If this was helpful, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can see the rest of my videos in the future. That's all for this week. See you next time.